of another project which was done for AD Studio. It's gonna be again art journal page. I'm taking an art journal page from my small handmade art journal, and I'm gonna be using two stencils from AD Studio, stencil number 59 and stencil number 3. And here I'm spraying stencil 59 with Tawny Turquoise. It's a moon shadow spray from Lindy's Gang. And I'm gonna be doing a reverse stenciling. So I'm dabbing off the excess of the paint from the borders because I don't want to have borders on the page. I'm flipping the stencil over, and with the tissue I'm pressing it onto the page, and like that I have a reverse stenciling image on the page. Just be careful to clean the stencil as always straight after using, so the paint doesn't stain your next project. For the next stencil, stencil number 3, I'm gonna be using green with an MV green. It's a Starburst Mist from Lindy's Gang also. And I'll do the same thing. I spray the stencil, I remove the excess of the paint with the tissue, and then I'm flipping over the stencil and applying the pressure with a tissue in my hand and applying the stencil onto the page. And look at that. This is the great way to optimize your stencils. So basically with one stencil you can have two different images, and I could have done for this project two different types of stenciling, the normal regular stenciling and also this reversed or negative stenciling, to just show you the difference in the print, but I'll just leave it for the next project. And here I'm adding some stamping. As always my pages are a little chaotic, I love that type of journaling. I'm adding a script stamp from Paper Poetry with Archival Ink Black, and this one is Memento Ink London Fog. This is some wooden stamp. I removed the wooden part. I'm just applying it randomly. And what will I do now? I forgot already. Oh, of course, I will do some splatter. This one is with Tawny Turquoise again. It's Moon Shadow Mist, which means that it has a brownish color. But then it has also another color to it, in this case it's green. And it's really lovely, it has a lovely shine. I really like it. The moon shadow mists are really nice. I just edged the ink the edges with walnut stain oxide ink. And right now I took a piece of die cut and I spray it with green with MV green and dry it. And I'm gonna place it on my page later. Here is the stamp from Carabel Studio. It's a texture mini damier stamp. And I will be embossing it, but not with a regular embossing powder, but with iced enamels by Rangers. It's a tarnished bronze. This one is actually, it has more texture to it. It's not flat at all, like, well, embossing powders are not flat, but this one has still more texture. It has small pieces of kind of stones. I don't know really how to explain. It's actually used more to do jewelry, but it works fine with embossing pad. And it you dry it exactly like you would dry a embossing powder. And as you could see just a second ago, when I'm drying either my paint or embossing powders, I like to dry it first from one side and then change the side and dry it from the back, simply because in this case you will have less warping of the paper. And now I'm using paper dolls by Tim Holtz, and I think that's a part of the tag, is a part of his ephemera. My die cut, which I colored before, and a piece of old vintage tape, washi tape. I'm not sure if you've noticed, but when I'm doing my art journal pages, I usually add something in metal. I like very much metal, so I'm either adding brass or wire, or in this case it's a paper clip. So splatter, metal, borders, that's usually a must for me. The die cut I glue with a tacky glue, and the rest with the double-sided foam tape. The pieces of washi tape, which are actually on top of the tag, they are not glued on the side. I left them on purpose like that. And here I'm adding, I'm not sure the circles from the text, looking for a place for the third one. When I was learning how to do art journaling, well, I'm still learning, but I heard that what's attractive for the eye is actually odd numbers. So when you are using pieces like that, it's better to add three circles, for example, than two. That's why I was struggling with the third one. And of course, as I said to you, I need to add borders. For me, the pages rarely finish when there are no borders. And for the sentiment, I'm using 7-dot studio word stickers. It's from the collection Paint Chips. And basically, that's it. Thank you so much for being here with me, for watching my art journal page. If you have any questions or just want to leave me a comment, please do so. I'm always very happy to read your comments. If you can subscribe to my channel, that would be great also. And as always, I'm gonna leave you the link to Aga Baraniak shop, where you can buy these lovely stencils, also stamps and so much more. And also I leave you a link to her Facebook page, AB Studio. And you can also win Aga stencils by taking part in the YouTube Hop, which is on my channel, and I'm gonna give you a link just here. Thank you so much for watching, and see you next time. Bye!